close the door.
Sure. Cherry! How come you got off the bus without letting me know?
Shut the door, cowboy.
How come you wanna slip off the bus like that and come in here all by yourself?
Where was you brought up, in a barn?
That's right, he was.
What's the matter with you, mister? You afraid of a little fresh air?
Man's right, Bo, it's cold out there.
Well, that don't give him no right to insult my manners. No man ever had to tell me what to do, did he, Verge? Well, did he?
You opened the door. You should have closed it. That's all I'm saying.
Door's closed now, so what you arguing about?
Jerry, let you and me sit down and have it. That's your suitcase, ain't it?
For crying out loud, will you leave me be?
Well, ain't that your suitcase?
Yes, that's my suitcase. Grr!
What'd you bring it in here for? Cherry, I'm asking you a civil question. What did you bring your suitcase in here for? Now tell me.
You keep away from me, Bodecker.
Oh, well, George, you keep out of this. This is between me and Cherry. Was you trying to fool me again? Is that what it was?
Take your hands off of me, Bo.
Tell me. Cherry, you tell me.
Okay, cowboy. Leave the lady alone.
You better keep out of this too, mister, if you know what's good for you. It ain't none of your business, nohow.
I ain't so sure about that. A bus driver's kind of like the captain of a ship, you know. The welfare of the passengers is his responsibility. If anything happens in the bus...
We ain't in a bus!
We're in a bus stop. This here is an official, authorized bus stop. Ain't it, Grace?
When the sign's up.
Well, you still got no right interfering between two people gonna get married.
We ain't getting married. That's what I've been trying to tell you, but you're too bullheaded and mean to listen.
Jerry, I'm telling you, you're going to marry me, and I ain't going to discuss it no more.
Now, there must be a preacher around here someplace, ain't there?
Down the road a ways, but he's asleep.
Well, we're going to wake him up and put him to work.
Oh! Help, everybody!
Oh, shut up. I made you a good husband. You have nothing to be sorry about.
No! I'm telling you, cowboy. No! No! Now, put her down.
No! Open the door, Bert. No! Go ahead, Verge. Open the door.
I ain't gonna open it, Bo.
You ain't?
No.
You've been again this right from the beginning.
That's right. First, because I figured the lady wasn't good enough for you. But now, because I figure you ain't good enough for her.
That's how it is, cowboy. Now, are you gonna put her down?
You're gonna get out of my way.
You're gonna have to fight me first.
I love a good fight.
One thing I can't stand is a bully.
Who says I'm a boy?
I do!
Quiet!
A man's got to fight for what he wants.
There's a big difference between a fighter and a bully, Bo. But there's only one way you're gonna learn it. For once in your life, somebody's gotta beat the living tar out of you. Go to it, Captain. He's right for it. I'd do it myself if I was big enough. But you ain't big enough. And neither is he!
Ain't no man ever got the best of me, and there ain't gonna be!
Well, I'm willing to try, cowboy. Just step outside.
Delighted!
No one but Marilyn could do justice to Bus Stop, the smash hit that had Broadway howling for more and more, with Arthur O'Connell, Betty Field, and Hope Lang as her traveling companions. And just look at the guy who ropes Marilyn, introducing Hollywood's newest hunk of man, Don Murray. He didn't want her to know that when it came to women, he knew nothing but nothing. She didn't want him to know that when it came to men, she knew plenty, but plenty.
Of course, it's only what you might call a physical attraction.
Physical?
I mean, you're so big and strong and, well, so darn healthy looking.
Yes, I do keep myself in pretty good shape. Of course, you got it when you're competing in a rodeo like that, all class A of you.
You got this idea that a woman is like some animal you're trying to break.
That's right.
But there are some gals who don't like to be pushed and grabbed and lassoed and drugged into buses in the middle of the night.
He could ride like a fury, throw steers like a fiend, do push-ups like a champion. But when it comes to taming this filly, he really has a bronco by the tail.